Yasenchak. Arise to realize your true potential. Unleash your power and awaken the eyes of the world.
Hideki Kamiya, creator of the Devil May Cry series, has returned to the forefront of gaming to bring you Bayonetta. But does it work its magic? The game begins with the first of many insanely acrobatic fight scenes as the Umbran witch Bayonetta massacres a flock of angels. A hired gun for hell, Bayonetta earns her keep by doing what she does best, killing in skin-tight clothing. Unfortunately, and predictably, she has no memory, and over the course of the 10 or so hour single-player campaign, you'll slowly uncover her past and reveal her destiny. A formulaic approach, yes, but it's only the foundation of a deeper plot involving a young man named Luca and a little girl named Cereza. The latter in particular is especially important, as she instills a motherly instinct in the otherwise distant protagonist.
What a lovely tea party. And dancing, too. Cereza, my dear, watch and learn.
The gameplay is the heart and soul of Bayonetta, and it's about as smooth and flawless as it can get. Using hundreds of combos, you'll slaughter your way from hell to heaven on your journey to discover your true self. Always in your shadow is a rival witch, and the two of you will do battle on numerous occasions before the end. In addition to her iconic high-heel handguns, Bayonetta has a rather modest arsenal at her disposal of whips, katanas, claws, and shotguns, not to mention any weapon dropped by the enemy. But her strongest weapon is her hair of all things, which increases the range of her power of her attacks and transforms into various demons when dispatching larger bosses. Equally important as dishing out the damage is avoiding it. With no way to block, you can only dodge incoming enemy attacks. Dodge at the last possible moment, and you'll activate Witch Time, which slows down the world to a crawl, allowing Bayonetta to attack faster and even walk on water. The other powers include the ability to shapeshift into a panther and other animals, and walk on the walls and ceiling. But Bayonetta isn't alone. Backing her up is Rodan, owner of the Gates of Hell Tavern and a skilled weaponsmith. Using halos collected from fallen angels, you can purchase new magical techniques, weapons and accessories and items. And if you're low on cash, there's an item creation system that allows you to use various compounds to concoct healing and support items. The game is of average length, but with each segment being graded, many will feel obligated to replay certain segments to improve their score. You'll also die quite often on regular difficulty, but the challenge is never insurmountable. Checkpoints are sensibly placed to prevent too much repetition, and battles are appropriately broken up by the occasional platforming sections. While the regular combat is a blast, Bayonetta truly shines during the boss fights, all of which are so cinematic that they're almost disorienting. Whether it's fighting a dragon-like creature on a crumbling bridge, or fighting an even larger one in the eye of a tornado, the game always manages to leave you completely awestruck. Frankly, there's no better way to start 2010 than to purchase Bayonetta. Out on January 5th, it's a high-octane and adrenaline-pumping ride that no one should miss. The appealing characters, fantastic gameplay, and unparalleled style and flair will leave all gamers completely satisfied.